Welcome back to City Wrap Ramadan. Fasting in Islam is required for Muslims once they've reached puberty. But there are many times that the children of the house can't wait to get involved.
I'm sure. Well, many children do fast even before they are obliged to. But it's especially important that their developing bodies are properly nourished and taken care of this holy month. With us in studio to answer all our questions on youth and fasting is Safiq Ali, a dietitian from Wellcare Hospital. Hello, Hi. Shafiq. Welcome Hi. To the show. Since it's the holy month, we've been talking a lot about fitness. And when you speak about fitness for children, I've spoken to a lot of families and everyone has a different belief about when children are supposed to be fasting. Mm. You being an expert, what would you say is the ideal age for children to start fasting?
Well, it's not obligatory for children to fast until they hit the age of puberty. But many parents, if you see, they encourage their kids to fast even before that so that they get used to it and they also know the value and the worship of fasting. At least for a number of days, few days or a few hours in a day.
Is that healthy?
It is healthy because when you fast, you are actually detoxifying yourself. All the toxins in your body are released, so it is healthy. But on the other hand, if you see, Ramadan is a time of bonding with the whole family, you know? And especially the foods cooked at iftar, it is being shared with friends, family and neighbors. So this practice actually influences a lot the younger minds. So at a very young age, they develop a desire to practice fasting and involve in the activities of Ramadan.
What kind of food should they ideally be having once they break their fast?
Okay, if you ask me about the food for iftar, they should have something which is giving them quick supply of energy because they've been fasting for almost 14, 15 hours this year. So their body is deprived of any energy. So they need to have something quick. Fruits, fruit juices, dates, they all have quick source of energy. So something like that they can choose. But for suhoor is the other way, is the opposite. They need to have slow digesting, high fiber foods, which are digested slowly and they release sugar slowly, so they can get sustained energy throughout the day. The most important thing is water. They need to hydrate themselves during the non-fasting hours. And if the kid is not a kind who drinks a lot of water, then make sure they drink any other kind of fluids like, you know, clear soups or unsweetened juices or even foods which are high in water content like watermelon, oranges or jello, things like that, just to dehydrate them during the non-fasting hours.
That was very informative. It was lovely to have you on our show today and good luck with the rest of Ramadan.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. As always, Ramadan is packed with ways to fill your evenings with so much going on around town. Here are our diary dates for today.
Get your nightly Ramadan entertainment at Dubai Marina Mall. From 9 p.m. to 11 p.m., the central atrium is filled with the Middle Eastern sounds of live oud and tabla, making your shopping experience that much sweeter, running until the end of Ramadan.
For a different side of the Middle Eastern culture, you can also visit Dera City Center's Arabian Heritage Display, which features a henna station, Arabic tea and coffee service, and even falconers showing off their prize birds from 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. until the end of Eid.
And finally, something for the children this Ramadan. Celebrate Ramadan with everyone's favorite mascot, Modesh, at the Modesh World Ramadan Tent. Along with international and Arabic buffet, there are competitions and special cultural shows every night. And dining with Modesh gets you access to the venue for free.
Well, it's time for a break, but we will be back as Dina takes a peek into just how much more you can do with dates. Plus, we're giving away a Batil gift basket worth 1,000 dirhams. That's all through our Facebook page, City Wrap.
But that's not all we are giving away. We are giving 20 lucky viewers the chance to go down and fill the stands as UAE takes on FC Barcelona and Real Madrid at Dubai Sports World. We'll also be speaking to the organizers to find out just what we can expect to see. Don't go anywhere.